Hey guys, Mona and I have a different video for you this week. We are going to be ranking our Tom Ford eyeshadow quads. Normally we do a Top 5 Tuesdays where we give you our top 5 products for a particular category, but this week we thought we would just do something different. And this is something that you guys have been requesting from me for a very long time. I had done a ranking for Pat McGrath eyeshadow palettes, and ever since then, most of you have been asking me to rank my Tom Ford eyeshadow quads. So that's what I'm going to be doing today. I have 19 of them. This is probably going to be a long video. I'm really going to try and not talk about each one for too long. And this was an incredibly hard list to come up with. It was like picking between children. I love all of these palettes. I kind of want to give you that caveat up front. Even my least favorite quad, I still really love. And in terms of the quality of these eyeshadow quads, I find them all to be very good, to be excellent, to be very good, and to be very, very similar. So I couldn't really rank them due to their like quality. If like one had poorer quality, that would obviously fall to the end of the list. But they're all really, really good quality eyeshadows. So I really had to base them on how I like the colors and how often I use them. Those are basically the two parameters that I used. I also want to mention that I'm talking about all of the palettes that I have for Tom Ford. Some of them have been discontinued, some of them are limited edition and no longer available. So I decided to throw them all in there. We'll talk about them all. So I first saw these ranking videos from Kelsey Brianna J. The first one I think I saw from her is where she ranked her Natasha Denona palettes. It's such a fun video. If you guys haven't checked out her channel, definitely check it out. I think she's very clear in her thoughts. She gives you her opinion. She's very straightforward. Anyway, definitely check out her channel. So, okay, let's go through this incredibly painful task of ranking all of my Tom Ford eyeshadow quads. All right, first up is a palette that actually was just recently discontinued. This is the Last Dance palette. And I like all of these palettes. I feel like I'm going to be saying the same things for a lot of these quads too, so ignore my limited vocabulary. But anyway, this palette I bought for this color, this turquoise color. I use the turquoise color a lot. The other colors in here, I just didn't really use that much. I never, you know, I don't think, wow, I need a brown and would pull out this palette. It just never happened. If I wanted a really bright turquoise, then I come to this palette. But that's not often, and that's only one shade out of the four. So anyway, for those random reasons, this is why this is number 19 on my list. This palette is one of the newer palettes from Tom Ford, and you guys can probably guess which one this is, but this is the Photosynthesex Quad. And again, I really like this quad. I think it's a really interesting color combination. The quality is great. We have two satins, a top coat, and a matte shade here. And I think they're beautiful. I really love this top coat, but I just don't reach for it that often. And these are colors that I just don't really think of when I want to create like an eye look. If I do want to create a really bold kind of like green and yellow eye look, I definitely think of this, but really, it just doesn't happen very often. So number 18 on my list is the Photosynthesex. So next on my list is Seductive Rose. I'm not sure if this palette has been discontinued or not. Anyway, there are two top coats in here and two satin shades. This is, again, this is a very lovely palette, but I don't really reach for it that often. This shade is a little bit, kind of shows up a little bit chalky on my skin tone. It's a little bit too cool and too light, and so I don't use this shade too often. And then to have two top coats in here, it's very limiting. It's very limiting, and you don't really get a lot of different looks out of this, but I just find this palette to be, I don't know, maybe just a little bit dull. It's not very exciting. It's not very inspirational, I'll say that. When I open it up, I'm not really like inspired to do a look. So Seductive Rose is number 17 on my list. All right, I'm just looking at all the quads that are remaining. I really love all the ones remaining. This was really hard. So this is number 16 on my list. This is Disco Dust. I really like this quad. Basically has like four satin shades in here. There really isn't a top coat. This one is probably the most shimmery, but again, it's not like one of those sheer, really glittery, high glitter top coats that you see in a lot of the other quads from Tom Ford. So this is a bit more of like an everyday kind of quad. And this color is really, really beautiful. It's very mysterious because you want to call it like a a dark peach, or maybe it's a terracotta, but it's a little bit more subtle than that. It's really pretty. But this palette probably ended up towards the back of my list here, because when I do an eye look with this quad, I pretty much only get one eye look out of here. So this one is number 16 on my list, Disco Dust. All right, number 15 on my list is one of the newer quads, and this is African Violet. I mean, I really love this palette. I love these colors. I think they're really beautiful. I think they're really punchy. You get this great, like really, really warm, deep gold top coat, and then you have this beautiful orchid color. This is a really gorgeous palette. I just don't reach for it that often. It is a much brighter eye look than what I would normally go for. I think on a medium to deeper skin tone, this would be a great kind of like everyday palette, but when you're as pale as I am, these colors end up so bright on my eyelids that it really, at least for me, doesn't end up being a very wearable everyday eye look. It's really, really bright. But like I've said about all the palettes so far, it's really beautiful and I love the colors. I just don't reach for it that often. So this is number 15 on my list, African Violet. So next on my list is another new one from Tom Ford, and this is Leopard Sun. And I was just looking at my quads over there. Most of the ones towards the top of my list are quads that have been in my collection for a much longer period of time. And since one of my major considerations was how often I reached for a palette, I think that's why some of the newer ones have definitely ended up at the back of the list. But anyway, another palette, I mean, I just really, really love it. But I think for the same reasons as African Violet, the colors in Leopard Sun end up very, very vibrant on my pale skin. And I think it's incredibly beautiful, but it's just not a palette that I reach for often because of how bright, especially how bright this gold color is. It ends up actually being a little bit more orange than just, you know, straight up gold. But this color is gorgeous. I mean, I really, really enjoy this palette. Just not one that I reach for as much as the ones that are coming up. So Leopard Sun is number 14 on my list. All right, I'm being completely honest here. I feel like all the remaining quads, they could be shuffled in any sort of order and it would be fine. Like I really, really love all of them, but we're gonna do this, okay. So the next quad on my list is Daydream. And again, this is one of the newer quads from Tom Ford. I love this formula. This is the wet dry formula. And these colors look incredible when you wet your brush. Just absolutely gorgeous. I mean, I guess I'll say the same thing that I said for Leopard Sun and African Violet. Like this purple is incredibly, incredibly bright. So is this silver. These end up very, very bright on my lids. I mean, they're absolutely stunning. But again, not something I reach for every day. This is something that I kind of reserve. Like if I want a really kind of cool, shimmery purple tone look, this is definitely a palette that I would consider for a look like that. So Daydream is number 13 on my list. All right, this is number 12 on my list. I really enjoy this palette. I'm rethinking maybe my list here. No, I don't think so. I don't think so. All right, this is number 12. This is Iris Bronze. This was a limited edition quad from Nordstrom. It came in like a set and it came out during the anniversary sale. And then I think they re-released it during the holidays, again, in that little set. I think there were two lipsticks. Anyway, because of that, I don't use this that often. I try not to use too many limited edition products on my channel because if you guys can't get it, it's very frustrating. So that is probably why I've overlooked this palette and don't use it as much as maybe as I would, because it is really a palette that is very much in my wheelhouse. It is incredibly beautiful. As I understand it, the four colors in here are comprised of the four most popular colors from his singles line. So that's what we see here in this quad. And again, it's beautiful. I have absolutely no complaints about the quality. The color selection in here actually is really nice. This is a matte. We have a nice, beautiful satin here. This is a matte with little itty bitty like glitters in there, like really itty bitty. And then this is a satin as well, but just not quite as shiny as this one. So another really beautiful one. So this is number 12 on my list, Iris Bronze. All right, number 11 on my list. God, this is a quad I really love too. This is Virgin Orchid. This is one of the newer releases from Tom Ford. And this, again, is in that beautiful, like, wet, dry formula. You can see how much I've used this. The pans look really abused. This is gorgeous. It's absolutely beautiful. I think this has ended up at 11 because it is newer and I have not reached for it quite as much as the older ones that I have in my collection. But this is really pretty. There is a very distinct color story though, so maybe that's why I have this at 11. It's not quite as versatile as some of the other, or universal, I should say. It's not quite as universal as some of the other palettes that I have. You'll see, like my top eight maybe, all have kind of a very similar look to them. Anyway, so this Virgin Orchid is number 11 on my list. All right, we are down to the top 10. We are getting there. So number 10 on my list, this is another newer one from Tom Ford, and this is Pretty Baby. I've come to really, really love this palette. It is, I think when I reviewed this palette, I think I mentioned this, that this is a sneaky one. This is one that I think was released with all of those other ones that looked a lot more exciting in the pan, but this one is absolutely stunning. Like this top coat, do you see that beautiful duochrome that's going on? This color is also very mysterious. This dark brown isn't just a plain old dark brown. All four of these colors have a lot more depth to them, and so I feel like you can actually create a few different looks with just these four shadows. It's just a really stunning, stunning palette. I got so excited using this palette one day that I even kind of gouged it out there, but beautiful, beautiful palette. So this is number 10 on my list. All right, number 9 on my list. This is one that has been discontinued. It broke my heart to hear that this one was discontinued because this is a really lovely palette, but this one is Silvered Topaz. We've got the great top coat shade here. You can see how beautiful and reflective that is. And then we have a silvery gray, we have more of a taupey brown, and then we have a matte dark brown here. I thought this palette was really great because it looked like it was kind of split between cool and warm tones, but these are actually very, very cool. The undertone of these shadows are very cool, even though they're a bit of a brown, but these shadows just go really beautifully together. I'm really sad that they discontinued this one, but this is a gorgeous one, and I like the different finishes in here. We have two satins, this top coat, and this is like a true matte. A true, true matte. There are no little glitters in there. It's not a little bit shimmery on the skin when you swatch it. This one is like a solid matte. So this one is number 9 on my list, Silver Topaz. What did I say about Silver Topaz? That one, Silver Topaz was number 9 on my list. Is that what I said? Anyway, it's number 9 on my list. This one is number 8. I was actually surprised that this ended up as number 8 for me. I don't know why. Anyway, let me just show you. This one is Nude Dip. And this is in that wet dry formula that I really love. I really love this palette. I just don't reach for it quite as much as the remainder of these. It's a beautiful, beautiful palette. I mean, it's absolutely gorgeous. I think the minor issue that I have is that these three colors, while they're different, they show up a little bit differently on the skin. If you start to kind of blend them all together, they're all kind of like the same idea on your eyes. You only have this one here to kind of give your eyes a little bit of dimension. But these three shades are gorgeous, like one shadow lid colors, like absolutely gorgeous, especially if you wet them. Oh my God, they turn into this like beautiful, like metallic, I almost said paste, but like metallic, like cream shadow, just gorgeous, gorgeous. I love this. So Nude Dip, this one is number 8 on my list. All right, number 7 on my list is a new one. This is Super Nouveau. I love this palette. It's really gorgeous. I think this is why Silver Topaz was discontinued. I kind of went back and forth. I was like, well, do I like Silver Topaz more? Do I like Super Nouveau more? I really like them both. I think I like the variety of the finishes in Silver Topaz more, but I like that this is not a top coat because you get an actual like another shadow, like another color to play with. And I find like this shadow to be a little bit more chameleon-like than the one in the Silver Topaz. The Silver Topaz one is very cool. I feel like this one can lean a little bit warm, especially when you pair it with something this gold. And then using this black shade, you know, black is pretty universal. You can pair that with warm looks, you can pair that with cool looks. So I just feel like this palette is a little bit more flexible than Silver Topaz, and it's stunning. Supernuvo is number 7. I'm losing track. Yeah, number 7 on my list. All right, number 6 on my list. I think this one has been discontinued also, but this is the one that I feel like just screams evening. This is like the evening look palette. This one is Titanium Smoke. Oh, it's just, this one is just beautiful. Talk about sexy. This is a very, very sexy quad right here. If you just have a little black dress on, woo. This just totally turns up your entire look. I love it. And this one happens to have 2 top coats. This top coat has a bit more pigment in it than a lot of the other top coats. So this one actually can work more as just kind of just like a glittery shadow versus like it being a straight up top coat. This one is a straight up top coat. It's pretty sheer. And then we have this black, which is a matte. And then this silver is like, it's like a demi matte. I wouldn't go so far as to call it a satin. It really doesn't have that much sheen, but it's not as flat as this black. But you just, like I said, you just get such a beautiful evening, dramatic, sexy look from this quad. I just love it. So Titanium Smoke is number 6 on my list. All right, all right, all right. We are at our top 5 now. And this one actually just appeared in my favorites, but this one is a limited edition palette. I think it's pretty much sold out online. If you have like an essay that you work with at a Tom Ford counter, they can probably find one for you. And I think this was exclusive to Neiman Marcus. Anyway, this is number 5 on my list, and this is the White Suede Quad. I just completely fell in love with this quad. I really just was not that optimistic about the looks that I could get out of this quad. I was kind of like, eh, I don't really care about this color combo. I was a little bit confused by this really cool grayish blue next to this fairly warm brown. I was like, how is that gonna work? It works beautifully. I absolutely love it. And this shade here versus like a light shade that's like in the Seductive Rose, it doesn't look chalky at all. This just looks like a beautiful, like light pink, ballet pink, like satin ribbon on my eyes. I just really love this quad. This top coat is beautiful. It's just stunning, stunning quad. So White Suede, number 5 on my list. I wonder if you guys can start guessing what is left, because you guys know what I have in my collection. You guys know what I love. You guys probably knew what my top 4 or 5 would be, but I wonder if you know the order. Anyway, this is number 4 on my list, and this is the Honeymoon palette. Gorgeous. This palette, I feel like, this may have taken like the Tom Ford Beauty Lover by storm. This, I think, was like sold out over and over and over again. You could not get this palette. This came out right before like the warm palette became like super, super hot, and everyone was dying to get their hands on this. And it is. It's absolutely stunning. It's absolutely gorgeous. And like I said before I started this list, I feel like the top 6 to 8 of these quads, you could mix them up. And I love them. I love them all. I love them all. But this is that wet dry formula. I'll never forget. I went to the Tom Ford counter at Nordstrom in Chicago, and the girl there, she was beautiful. So I was just kind of staring at her, but she had the most beautiful eyeshadow. She just had one color on her lid. She had a liquid eyeliner and that was it. She was stunning. And I was like, what eyeshadow is that? And she said, it's this one from the Honeymoon palette. And I thought, that doesn't look like that on me. But she said that she puts down like a layer of wet, and then she puts like a layer of it dry on top. She says she just like kind of like lays it on because it looked like her lid was gilded. It was so gorgeous. So the Honeymoon palette is number 4 on my list. So this next quad on my list probably would not have made it this high up if Tom Ford had not featured this in his runway for spring summer 19. When he featured it last fall. And this is the Golden Mink quad. This one is still around. It has not been discontinued. And this is one that I used occasionally in my collection, but when he featured it and it just looked so beautiful on all the different models, of course, I'm sure there were other products in play. I just started using it more and more, and it's really beautiful. You get a really easy, sultry, bronzy kind of look. It really is perfect for like spring, summer. It's just gorgeous. It has two top coats, and then it has two satin shades. It's just a really easy to wear kind of eyeshadow palette, and you can just stick with these two and then add just a top coat for an evening look. Like, it's easy. This is kind of like a throw in your purse kind of quad. So this is number 3 on my list. So what ended up in number 2 is Coco Mirage. I adore this palette. This is still around. It has not been discontinued, but this is the best basic neutral palette. I know it looks simple. I know it looks super, super basic, but it is so easy to use. I feel like it can work for a multitude of skin tones. I think it's just great for every single day. And if anyone asks me, like, can you recommend one Tom Ford eyeshadow quad for me to start with? I want to say 99% of the time, I just say go for Coco Mirage. It's super basic. You're probably going to be bored to tears when you look at it, but you'll use it. You'll use it a lot. You'll use it all the time. It'll be like the blue jeans or the black sweatpants of your makeup collection. So Coco Mirage is number 2 on my list. And finally, I'm sure you guys can guess what is number 1 on my list because it's the only thing left. It's also what I have on my eyes. This has been long discontinued, like long, long discontinued. I wish they would bring it back. And I believe this was a quad that was developed by Charlotte Tilbury when she was the creative director for the Tom Ford makeup line. And this is Cognac Sable. The elusive Cognac Sable. It's just perfection. It is obviously warm leaning, but again, I think it's so universal. I think it can work for so many different skin tones, and it can go from day to evening really easily, and it's so easy to work with. I am no makeup artist, but I feel like every time I use this palette, I get a pretty, you know, like sassy kind of look, and I just feel like there's no quad out there quite like this. I think the closest one, and a friend of mine pointed this out to me, the closest dupe, and it's still, I use the word dupe very, very loosely, is the Viseart 6-Pan Theory Palette in Minx. It's still not a complete dupe. There's still going to be shadows in there that don't really quite match up. The finishes are a little bit different, but the tone, like the color story, is similar. But Cognac Sable, number 1 on my list. I wish they would just bring this back. I don't know why this is retired. They just bring it back. So that is all 19 of my Tom Ford eyeshadow quads ranked. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please give it a thumbs up if you did. Please let me know what your favorites are. If you agree with my ranking at all, let me know down below in the comments section. Subscribe down below if you haven't already, and I'll see you in my next video.